نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي امين يا رب العالمين. The topic for today is all about udhiya or qurbani. Offering a sacrifice on Eid al-Adha is an act of worship that you should do if you can afford it. If you can't, you don't have to do it. One sacrifice, that means a goat or a sheep, is enough on behalf of the head of the household, his wife, kids and family living under his roof. You do not have to offer sacrifice for each member of the family. Seven people may get together and share the sacrifice of a camel or cow, but it has to be seven shares in one cow or camel. Anything more or less is not correct. The sacrifice has to be from among the an'am animals, meaning either a sheep, goat, cow or camel. So for example, you cannot sacrifice a chicken. The time for this udhiya is from after the khutbah on the day of Eid until sunset on the 13th of Dhul Hijjah. But the sooner the sacrifice, the better. Offering the sacrifice is an act of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So offer the best animal, healthy, mature, free of fault. It's better if you slaughter the animal yourself, but you can also delegate someone else to do it on your behalf if you do not know how or for some other reason. If you are the one offering the udhiya, you should not cut your nails or hair starting from the first of Dhul Hijjah until the time you do that sacrifice. This is only for the one doing the sacrifice. Your family and the others that you are doing the sacrifice on behalf of do not have to do that. They can cut their nails and hair if they need to. The reason why cutting the nails and the hair is not allowed is to show unity, support and solidarity between the Hujjaj and those that are not going for Hajj. It is good to eat some from the udhiya and give some as charity. The Prophet said about the udhiya, eat some, store some and give some in charity. This is in Sahih Muslim. It is good to do the sacrifice in the city where you live, but if there is a more benefit of doing the sacrifice in a place other than your residence, such as poor relatives or other Muslims who are in greater need of the charity, then you can offer the udhiya in a place other than where you live. You can offer this one udhiya on behalf of all members of your family, both living and dead. The Prophet used to offer the udhiya on behalf of himself and behalf of the members of his family, including those who had previously died. For example, Khadija radiyallahu anha. It is not right to offer udhiya on behalf of the Prophet. The Prophet never taught us to do that, although he taught us everything we need as far as doing good deeds is concerned. Also, the Sahaba never sacrificed an udhiya on behalf of the Prophet ﷺ. If it was good to do that, they would have definitely done that, but they didn't. Besides, whatever good we do, the Prophet ﷺ automatically gets the rewards of it too. That's because he ﷺ said, whoever sets a good example in Islam which is followed after he is gone will have a reward like those who acted upon it, without it detracting from their reward in the slightest. This is in Sahih Muslim. A haji does not have to offer an udhiya because he is offering a hadi. The proof is the fact that the Prophet ﷺ did not offer an udhiya when he went for hajj. Rather, he offered a hadi. But if the person is going hajj by himself, he can leave some money behind with his family so that they can offer the udhiya. Sheikh Ibn Uthman said, the pilgrim should not offer an udhiya, rather he offers a hadi. Hence, the Prophet ﷺ did not offer an udhiya during the farewell hajj, rather he offered a hadi. But if we assume that he is doing hajj by himself and his family are in his homeland, then in that case, he should leave his family enough money to buy an animal and offer it as an udhiya. So he will be offering a hadi and they will be offering an udhiya, because the udhiya is only prescribed in places other than Makkah. But in Makkah, it should be a hadi. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam specified the ages of the animals to be sacrificed. He ordered that the lamb should be 6 months old, goats 1 year old, cows should have passed 2 years and started a third year, and camels should be 5 years old. He, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, never quit offering the udhya sacrifice. He used to sacrifice two rams right after Eid prayer, and Allah knows best.